Hello everyone, we are going to discuss about ergonomics. We will be seeing what is ergonomics, how is ergonomics used in the hotel industry, and that too specifically in the housekeeping department. So in this video we would be seeing about the meaning of, we will see what is the meaning of ergonomics, what is the significance of ergonomics, and its need in the housekeeping department of the hotels. Also, we'll see how are the ergonomics principles used in the housekeeping department. Friends, we all know that housekeeping is a very physically demanding and tiring job. Lot of strength is required and lot of hard work is required to do the work in housekeeping department. As per an estimate, every 3 seconds, the GRA changes his body positions while cleaning a room. Now, if we consider that it takes approximately 25 minutes to clean one room, and per day, around 16 rooms are supposed to be cleaned by a particular GRA, then in one day shift, approximately 8,000 different body positions are taken up by a single GRA. So you can see how much body movements are taking place in one day. And this is the reason there are a lot of injuries can happen in the housekeeping department. And rate of injuries that happen in the housekeeping department is nearly double as compared to other hotel staff. And also it is said that almost 50% of work-related injuries that take place in the hotel are in the housekeeping staff only. But there is a good news, we can reduce this risk if we follow the principles of ergonomics. So now first we will see what is ergonomics actually. The term that is ergonomics has been derived from two different Greek words. The words are ergon, that means work, and nomoi, that means natural law. So the word becomes ergonomics from two words, ergon and nomoi, that mean work and natural law. So we see actually the word ergonomics means it is the study of how the working conditions, machines, as well as the equipments can be arranged in such a way so that people can work safely and more efficiently without having risk of injuries at all, or maybe the injuries are minimized to greatest extent. Once Mr. J.W. Marriott, who was the owner of the J.W. Marriott hotels, he said for the management, we have to take care of the employees and they will take care of our guests. Means in case the management takes care of the injuries and the well-being of the employees working in the hotel, then only they will take proper care of the guests coming in the hotel. So in that sense, ergonomics becomes even more important for us, for means the hotel management. See, whatever in the housekeeping department, whatever work we are doing, whatever equipments we use or the furniture that is there, that causes lot of physical strain and fatigue in the work. That leads to MSDs, that is musculoskeletal disorder, or that is also called RSI, that is repetitive stress injuries. And these are because of the static work and force. That means static work is when we are applying lot of energy in one position, or maybe if we are changing positions continuously. Because of those things, what happens on a particular group of bones or muscles, a lot of pressure is exerted, and if that pressure continues for a long time, that can lead to injuries or inflammation of those particular areas. So that is basically what we study in ergonomics, and we try to avoid these things or to reduce these things. Now we'll see what are the major kinds of risks involved in the housekeeping department. Broadly they can be divided into three. First is awkward posture, that means the body posture that is taken up by the employees working. Maybe they do not stand straight, or maybe when they pick up something or when they are sitting and doing some work, the body posture is not appropriate. That may lead to lot of risks, lot of injuries and all. Another thing, second risk, major risk could be excessive repetition. As we know, in the housekeeping department, lots of works are to be done again and again on a daily basis by the staff. Maybe it's cleaning of guest room, maybe it's cleaning of the public area, or maybe any other work in the department. There is lot of repetition. If we keep on doing same work again and again, what happens is there is lot of pressure and exertion on a particular group of muscles that I earlier told also, and that can lead to injuries. That is again a risk factor. The third major risk factor is high force. If we apply lot of pressure on a particular body part, or maybe we pick up very heavy things, or we push or pull something, so that can cause lot of high pressure over a particular area of our body, and then that can also lead to injuries or stress. Now all said and done, how can we mitigate the risks of these things in the housekeeping department? Maybe we can follow these 5 points that can help in reducing or decreasing the risks of injuries in the housekeeping department. The first one we can say is modifying the workplace layout and equipment. If we modify the layout in such a way that we do not have to move too much, without having less movements, we can do our work easily and comfortably. Plus, the equipments that we use, they are appropriate, they are easy to handle, they are not too heavy, or maybe they don't have sharp edges or something that can lead to some injuries. This can reduce the risk. Second point is modifying loads that are lifted, or the way of lifting has to be modified. Maybe probably the way we lift a particular thing, instead of just bending our back and lifting it up, if we sit down, bend our legs, keeping our backbone straight, and then pick up the thing, that could be better way. Then next point would be modifying personal habits. Many of us have a habit that our body posture is not appropriate. Maybe we stoop or we lean forward when we are walking or standing or doing something. Maybe we are, whenever we are sitting, we are bending our back, or maybe our legs are not at proper angle. That can lead to injuries. So we have to modify our habits accordingly. Then controlling the work environment. The environment of the area where we are working, that has to be modified a little bit. Like maybe there should be proper space for movement. If we have to pick up some things from a particular area, maybe say in a store or a housekeeping pantry, there has to be proper space so that we can sit down, we can move, we can pull and push the things in a proper way. Redesigning work practices. We have to plan our work in such a way that we do not do lot of repetitions. Maybe if we have to do one work repeatedly, we should take some breaks. Maybe after working for say half an hour, we should take a break of 2-3 minutes, stretch our body so that the muscles are not strained, a particular group of muscles is not strained. Also, another suggestion that can be given is when we have to do some heavy work, we should plan it in such a way that at the starting of the shift, we do that heavy work instead of doing it in the last. Why I am saying this is because if we do that work in the last, by that time we are already exhausted, our muscles are already exhausted by doing lot of work for last 7-8 hours, then they are more prone to injuries. So if we do the heavy work or more strenuous work or the work that requires lot of energy on our part in the starting, then there are less risks of injuries. Now I'll show you few examples of some correct and incorrect techniques. See, first I'm showing you these things. If we are pulling something, we have to keep our body in such a way that almost all the force that is there is in a straight line. If you see here, if we are moving some heavy object, again it has to be in straight line. And when we are doing some work, like maybe the tailor is doing some work, we have to stand straight. And I am showing you some incorrect ways that generally people do. If we do work in this way, then there is bending, So there is risk of injury or lot of stress, RSI would happen in this area. Similarly here, if the body posture is not right, again there are lot of problems that can happen. Same is the case here. Instead of standing straight, if bending here, then this backbone and this muscles of the neck, they are at high risk. I'll show you some more examples. Whenever we have to pull something, this is the wrong way. We are here in the back picture, our legs are straight, we are bending our back. This is wrong way. Instead of that, what we should do is we should bend our legs and then pick up the things. See, what happens is when we are doing it in wrong way, you can see this, the force is not in a straight line, so there is a risk here. But in the proper way, when we have bent the legs, the pressure is here and all these things are in straight line. So here at the neck as well as on the back, there are no or very less chances of injury. Similarly, in the room, in the guest bathroom, when we have to clean the wall near the bathtub, we should step inside the bathtub and clean the wall. That should not be the case that we are standing outside the bathtub and then we are bending and cleaning the wall. That would be wrong. That can cause a lot of fatigue as well as injuries. I'll show you some more examples. While making bed, what do you think? This is right or wrong? This is absolutely wrong way. We should not keep our legs straight and then bend our back while we are tucking the bed sheet inside. Instead of it, the proper way, the appropriate way is this. We should sit down by bending our legs and try to keep our back straight so we do not fatigue much, plus there are less chances of injuries. Likewise, if you see while sitting, this posture is not appropriate. Again, this we are bending, leaning at the back. This is again wrong. We should sit straight. This is the proper posture that is to be followed. Now, in a nutshell, what we have discussed is to avoid, to decrease the risk factors of injuries, we have to be very, very careful. We have to follow the principles of ergonomics. We should try to stretch throughout the shift, especially when we have to do some strenuous work or any work that requires a lot of awkward positions. So before that, we have to stretch our body, and once that activity is over, again we have to stretch our body. So that would decrease, that would mitigate the risks of injuries. We should pay attention to our body, and we should know our physical limitations. Like suppose if we cannot lift a heavy object by our own, we should take somebody's help. Or either what we can do is instead of holding heavy things together, we should split the weight. Like suppose when we are picking up the linen from the laundry, whenever we are bringing the linen to the pantry, instead of carrying a heavy weight of linen, we may take it in batches so that we are carrying less weight at a particular time. So that would again decrease the risk of injuries because we should know how much weight can be comfortably carried by us. That is just an example. Then, if we notice there are some issues related with the ergonomics, then they have to be taken care of. They have to be informed to the higher management, to the appropriate authorities, through your supervisors and managers. Very important thing, ergonomic related injuries are preventable, and we ourselves, we means the staff working in the housekeeping department, are responsible for our own safety. We have to be careful while doing a work so that we reduce the risk. So that's it for today. Thank you very much. Take care of yourself. Be safe. Thank you once again. Take care.